Morning, everybody. Welcome to my English class. Today we are going to see a new topic, but at the beginning we are going to remember the topic of the last week. So pay attention. How do you farm gerunds? Okay, you are going to farm gerunds adding ing to the verb. For example, reading, playing, smoking, that are gerunds, okay? And how do you form the negative form of infinitives? Okay, we are going to make the negative form of infinitives using the word not. For example, not to play, not to swim, not to write, okay? As I said before, today we are going to review a new topic that is called past passive. And what is the objective for today? The objective is to explain the use of the past passive in sentences, to use it to speak about the object, okay? And at the beginning, tell me, students, do you know when do you use past passive? And do you know what is the structure? Okay, we are going to see in order you learn, okay? At the beginning, you have to know that in English, we have two voices, active and passive voice. The active voice is the common sentence. It means we are going to use when the action of the verb is done to the subject. It means our subject do the action, okay? It says subject is doing the verb. In this case, we have the example. The leopard subject chase the verb, in this case in past form because ed, okay? The leopard chased the antelope, okay? It means that my subject is doing the action, okay? That is a normal sentence, a common sentence. I have my subject, the verb, and the complement, okay? That is an active voice when the subjects do the action, okay? Very simple. Let's go to see passive voice. When do you use passive voice? We have to use when you are going to focus on the action. It is not important who or what is making the action. Okay? In this case, I have an example. The antelope was chased by the leopard. It means that I have my subject, my verb in passive, and my complement, but in this case, this subject is not doing the verb, okay? That is the difference. With the passive voice, the action of the verb is done to the subject. It means this action is not doing for the subject, okay? In this case, it doesn't matter who makes the action, okay? Es decir, en la voz activa nosotros nos vamos a preocupar en quién hizo la acción. En este caso, el leopardo cazó al antílope. It means the subject makes the action. El sujeto realizó la acción. In the passive voice, the subject is not doing the verb. En este caso quiere decir que nuestro sujeto no realizó la acción. Es decir, la acción recae en el sujeto, pero el sujeto no realiza esta acción. ¿Qué nos dice aquí? El antílope fue cazado by the leopard. ¿Ok? It means that my complement or my object is who makes the action. Es decir, mi objeto, se podría decir, es quien realiza la acción, más no el sujeto. That is the difference. inactive voice, the subject, do the action. And in passive voice, the subject is not doing the action. Okay? Yeah, we are going to see the structure. In order to form past passive, you have to use the subject, the was and were, the verb in past participle, and the complement. Here we have an example. The cake was eaten by Carla. Okay, pay attention there. I'm going to use the subject, in this case the cake. I am using was because my subject is singular, and the verb in the past participle and my complement. Okay, when do you use was and when do you use were? Pay attention there. You are going to use were for you, we, you, they, and was you are going to use for he, she, it, and I. Okay, for the, in these cases you are going to use was. Okay, as I said before, we are going to use the subject was and were and the verb in past participle. Remember, we have regular verbs and irregular verbs. And what is the past participle form? Pay attention. You are going to use the third column. Usted va a utilizar la tercera columna of your list verbs. Usted va a utilizar esta columna. Okay? In order to form past passive. If it means you are going to use swam, thought, both, spoken, done, sold, eaten, run, put, gone. Okay, in this case you have to study in order to know what is the past participle form. Yeah, pay attention. In the case of the regular verbs, that is the same. You are going to use the third column. But pay attention, how do you form regular verbs? You only have to add ed to the verb. Accept, accept. Agree, agreed. Ask, asked. Believe, believed. Call, called. It means in the case of the regular verbs, you only have to add ed in order to form the past participle form. Okay, here we are going to see how do you convert the active voice to the passive voice. Remember, both has the same example, the same structure. Here we have an active voice. Maria sent a letter to her mother. We are going to form in past passive. Remember, the active voice has to be in past, sent. That is the past form of the verb sent. Okay? The letter was sent. I am using my subject, was and were. The verb in past participle, I mean complement. The letter was sent by Maria. Okay? So that is the way that we are going to convert. Pay attention. In this case, we change the order. Okay? In this case, the letter. In this case, that is my subject, my verb, and my object. In this case, my object is going to be my subject in the past passive. The letter was sent by Maria. Okay? Maria is the person who sent, who make the action. In this case, who sent? Maria. Okay? It means Maria realiza la acción. Okay? In past passive. La letra, la carta fue enviada. Es decir, la carta no realiza la acción. It means Maria is the person who sent the letter. We change the order. The letter was sent by Maria. Okay? We are going to see in this case another example. The active voice. They stole a bank. Okay? The stole is the passive form of steal. They stole a bank. And in order to pass, to convert to past passive, a bank, pay attention to the order, a bank was stolen. In this case, it doesn't matter if you put by someone. Como les había dicho, en la voz pasiva no necesitamos saber quién realizó la acción. Entonces no necesito poner who makes the action. It's not necessary. No es necesario. Por lo tanto, a bank was stolen. That is okay. I am using my subject, my auxiliary was, and I am using the verb in past participle. Okay, and that is all for today. Tomorrow we are going to review the negative past passive. Okay, I'm going to send a little homework for you. So pay attention and thank you.